Okay, today the wife asked me to I did a video. First of all, I did a video a while back where I had to replace I'm trying to think of the name. I'm getting old. I can't remember shit anymore. Not as fast. The wiper motor sprayer, windshield wipers motor sprayer thing. Anyway, I noticed, I looked at the brake pads and they were almost gone. So I'm gonna change the oil, take that apart, see if the discs are any good. And if the discs are good, I'll just replace the pads. If not, I will do the pads and the disc, because like I said, I just did my truck and or one side, and it's cheaper just to buy a new disc than to get them turned. And if you don't get them, and they're not smooth, they will squeak or pull. It just isn't, you might as well just do it. So I'm gonna go down and do that. And she bought this 2019 Jeep cash, and she's got a really good job. And she lost all the paperwork, all of it, everything. And she bought extended warranties for oil changes, windshield chipping, powertrain. And she asked me to take in the Jeep, but I didn't have the paperwork. And so, man, I had a hell of a time getting a copy of all that paperwork. Finally, I had to go in the down here. There's a place called Titus, Willis Titus or something like that. It owns most all the auto dealerships, or a lot of them. So after a bunch of phone calls going back and forth, I finally had to go into his office. I stayed calm, because I do have a temper sometimes, because of all my years working with the idiots. And anyway, I finally walked out, got the oil, got the maintenance done on her car free, because it was on the one of the agreements, and I got all the paperwork. And why am I telling you this? Because, or why am I telling me? Because I'm, again, I just record myself. Because she was driving the Escape, and I couldn't do the brakes. She didn't want to drive anymore. And then I looked into it to see what the oil changes were for these newer Jeeps. And it's 10,000 miles. That's to keep your warranty, you only have to change it 10,000 miles. So then I started looking through the whole schedule, and everything is at 10,000 miles intervals, Like every time is rotate the tires, change the oil every 10,000 miles. And then you get into spark plugs and safety checks and all that, but it's all 10,000 mile increments. So usually I do all the maintenance myself, but she wanted to get this because I'm getting old. She wanted to get this have them work on the Jeep. I think that's why she did it. I think she trusts me. And And anyway, so it looks like I'm not gonna have to be working on the Jeep, because it's fully covered, bumper to bumper. For 3 years, and then like 6 years for powertrain. Anyway, so again, you get retired, you look for stuff to do. So I kind of enjoy making these videos. I noticed that I shuffle my feet when I walk around. I don't, if you watch this video, go back. Almost every video, I'm like dragging my feet. They're going like a sliding on the floor. I think that's because my back is bad. I think I've somehow fallen into a habit of not picking my feet up like I used to. It's weird. The weird things happen when you get old. You think you never will, but you do. So it's, again, kind of the fun of the video is you see yourself, and you are what you are, and you just keep going. So that's what I'm going to do today. Again, I always get sidetracked. I always talk. Oh, I put up some hangers for my guitars. I didn't like the stands. But if you do get these hangers, if you have some guitars, get these kind. They swivel, because on an electric guitar, you could have a problem here. So it's slightly, back up, slightly tilted this way. So these things, they pivot. That's it. Okay, down in the shop. I think it's a 211 escape, I forget. I'll have to look. Anyway, change the oil. Check out the brakes. Get the wheels off, then I'll get back. I didn't break them loose before I lifted the car. Damn it. As luck would have it, I'm missing a 19 millimeter half inch deep socket, so I gotta use my 3/8. It's always something. So I got this side off. We'll get the other side. Okay, I've never changed brakes on this car before. So, gotta figure it out.
put some kind of rubber boot on here. I think there's an Allen head in there. I can't see it.
A metric, of course. See if I can find one. Yeah, seven millimeter Allen. It's got like a rubber boot around the Allen head. And these go in the back. I don't have a manual for this car. Not very tight. Of course, I didn't bring a 3/8 socket wrench over here. Get a wrench. Okay, I always say take pictures. Can't hurt. Back out a little bit. That'll show me where the spring goes. Back here, I don't think it matters. To push the bolt out the rest of the way.
went back out. I think this should pop out. This spring is holding it. The spring bends, yeah. Not sure how to get that out. Like that. I think there's one on the back. Maybe I should take this off. I gotta find some way to hook this up. this disc is okay. So, all I need to do is compress that. Somehow, so I can get the thicker shoes in. This one here, I don't know if you can see it. It's got about an eighth left. About an eighth. I think the other side is worse. Anyway, I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. And then try to compress that. So it's only two bolts. Two bolts and one spring. If you catch these in time, you save a lot of money. If you don't have the right tools, you gotta do whatever you got. To compress. I wish I didn't have holes in the center of these. Make my life a lot easier. I'll just push fluid back into the reservoir. Trying to push the piston in. Again, these are clamps I used to use in construction. That's it. They're both good. See if I can get a close-up of these pads. Hang on. Again, you gotta catch it before you get too far, or your cost will, if you take it to a shop, or quadruple. In this case, it says right on the dipstick, or right on the crank filler, what it's supposed to be. What kind of oil? $520.
So again, I just take a picture. Why not? I got this camera. Why not just use it?
See if the manual says how much.
Well, door's locked. Anyway, that's it. Again, part of this is I do it so I don't look stuff up again. So here's the manual, owner's manual. Capacities for refilling fluid. Engine oil. Let's see what size engine this is. It's a 3.0. 6 quarts. It also says 520 premium synthetic or Motorcraft SE520. I'll take a picture of that. I don't usually put synthetic because I switch it to like every 3,000 miles. Like the Jeep that she bought, it says 10,000 miles. That's an awful long ways if you ask me. Okay, I already put the other side together.
Pop these bolts out, you slide, re-lubricate them. Not going in. There it is. This also keeps her from squeaking. It's on the back of that piston. Get some length. Anything metal can squeak. the back of these off. Like this off, where the disc is going to sit. Back, same thing. Put that on there because it's going to be rubbing against here. Even that's a kind of a non-friction plate. I'll put it on here afterwards so I don't get it all over myself. These are going to fit into these slots over here. Again, I have it on there, but a little extra here. Put some on the back of here because that's gonna, the brake's gonna hit here. Anywhere they're gonna touch. I already cleaned everything with brake cleaner, non-chlorinated. Again, you gotta make sure you get enough room, that's why I compressed the piston. This thing, you need to be able to slide easy. That's where I put the lubricant there. I'm just going to put that in place. Make sure these bolts are back far enough. I got lubricant. Let's see, I got lubricant here, here, there, there. Light out of the way. fit those discs sat fit in the same spot opposite of that. Line this bolt up. Your socket ready ahead of time. Start by hand. Make sure you're in there. Tighten it all the way up till I get the other one in. It's pretty tight and back it off in here. Slipped in. Again, I'll just do it by hand and make double sure I'm not going to strip anything. It's okay. Tight. I'm just gonna make it about as tight as I took it off. I'm gonna use my own torque. Put this rubber boot back in. You see, that's the way it's supposed to be. It's because until I step on the pedal, this thing's not going to get tight, but it's supposed to slide like that. And I don't have to bleed it because I didn't let any air in the system. Tight. Put this cap back on. First car I saw with a cap. My nuts over here. Plug the light. I need the cord for the impact. Get it out of my way. On this tray.
kind of line your holes up, looking in there. Like that. Start these by hand. Making sure the wheel's all the way back. That's good. When I bought the right size socket when I was out. Plugged in. Let's get these touching. Okay, the pattern just kind of go like this. Just something like that. These are kind of oblong because I had the wrong socket before, but this is fixing it. Push on the brakes. Still gotta change the oil. Start it up. Okay, brakes are good. Took about 3 pushes. Push the cylinders against the disc. And I can't lower it because I gotta change the oil. I'll do that now. And I bought enough oil to do 2 oil changes for this car. And two oil changes for my truck. And it says get Ford Motor Company. It doesn't matter. Oil's oil. As long as you change it every 3,000-4,000 miles, that's it. I'm turning it back on because I forgot to put that spring in, like a dumbass. Should come loose.
took this spring out, and this is a new one. There we go. Just keeping these two things tight. Again, look through there, line up these nuts, or else you have to fight it. I just try to get two of them on. So the wheel doesn't wiggle anymore. Glad I remembered to put that in. Getting old.